have that. I can do the same thing.
Good enough, that's good.
And that part of our task is to assist in that labor. So like the quote that was up there a couple slides ago, that everything takes its rhythmic course. That birth of the sun is taking place on time.
Ecliptic, more or less. The moon has, it goes along, but at a 5-degree angle. So the plane, it's really hard as one person to do this, but the plane of the ecliptic is like this, and then the moon kind of cuts it going that way, and that's the ascending node. It's going north of the ecliptic. It goes 5 degrees above, and then it goes the descending node coming back down. Got it? Not great times to sow seeds. Because it's a moment when the moon is actually crossing the plane of the ecliptic, and it's kind of just not a great open moment. It's already occupied with something happening. So anyway, I gray it out.
It's shaded.
And I don't like to black things out, so I keep asking, can we make it a little lighter gray, just so that people don't get overwhelmed and feel forbidden. But anyway, so you see, on the 3rd of February, that's today, at 21 o'clock is going to be an ascending node. So we aren't going to sow seeds tonight. Okay. And the same thing on Saturday the 16th at 22 o'clock. We're also not going to sow seeds at night. So it's often not even relevant. The next thing is this apogee and perigee thing. I don't have to draw for you. We can read it. Apogee is when the moon is, we heard that Kepler's first law is that the planets don't circle around, but they go in an elliptical path. It's very modest, the ellipse. But when the moon is at its farthest from the Earth, because we're looking at it from the point of view of a plant, not from the sun looking out from somewhere else. So when the moon is at its farthest, it's apogee. And when it's nearest, it's perigee. And now, actually, once I gave a workshop and I was trembling in my boots when Bernard Hoff was there. And I just felt so embarrassed to be giving a workshop with him there because I knew he knew tons more than me. And he enhanced this picture for me of apogee. Because you'd think, I mean, because it's such a gentle curve, why would exactly the moment of it being farthest away mean anything? It's a real question. But he said it's like a dance, and he likened it to a folk dance. You know, when you're going around and you meet your partner, and there's only one moment when you can actually grab on, and after that, you missed it. So, that was a great image of, you know, that it is a dance, and there is a kind of meaningful moment when I discovered Kepler's second law, myself, making the calendar, because I thought it should be that the moon is going around, it should be equal amounts of time for each thing every month, right? If Libra is just that long, I should be able to count on that it's going to take about that many hours each month. But it doesn't. That's why I have to keep calculating it. And the reason is that when it's going at perigee, it's going faster. And when it's at apogee, it's going slower. So can I get that? If there's a change in rate of movement, also related to apogee and perigee, but that doesn't really figure into anything. I just found it very exciting. Okay. Ascending and descending note is something that Maria Toon makes a big deal out of. I haven't met it. Do any of you work with the planting time and the transplanting times? A lot of pruning to do. You can't just prune for 2 weeks and then sit down for 2 weeks.
it's a race to get all the pruning done. So I don't know. Some of these things are, they may be true, but they may not be practical. I don't know. I mean, I'm interested to know. But I put it here so that you know that the arc of the moon is, yes, do you do work with it? Yeah, I think it would be great to have more. I'm kind of like keeping the space open for future researchers. That's what I figure my job is to make this available so that you guys will work with it and keep learning, you know, refine these insights and make them your own and make them practical for you. So anyway, as the moon's arc, like the sun, the moon does in 1 month what the sun does in 1 year. So the moon, when it's in Sagittarius, the arc is low, and the arc keeps going higher and higher. That, you know, it gets higher in the sky, and then when it's in the twins, there it is up there. Meanwhile, it's winter, because the sun is in Sagittarius. It's going to be opposite. And so with that ascending arc, so the lowest point is the running low. That's on the 5th. You see that? I would love to figure out a way to draw that is as visible as the phases. If anybody can figure that out, you get the prize. 3 free calendars. more if you want. Anyway, so that's the running low, the lowest point, the lowest arc of the moon. And then the next time from that, you see it's not visually satisfying. From the 5th until the 19th, the arc is gradually ascending until it reaches the highest point on the 19th. Got it? So that there's 2 weeks of the moon's arc ascending. And Maria Toon says that the turgor of the sap of the plant is in the upper part of the plant during the ascending part of the month, and that during the descending, so after the 19th and going now down until the next month, at the lowest point on the 5th of March, that's when the turgor, the sap is more focused on the lower part of the plant. And that, so if you wanted to transplant a plant, you want it to be all in itself. So you transplant when the sap is in the root part, move it over. And otherwise, if it's kind of breathed out, if it's in its exhaling phase, then you have a more weak plant and it's not going to stand the transplanting so much. Anyway, like I said, I haven't met people who really work with that. But there it is for you. Now the part that you wanted. The moon in the zodiac. So as the moon travels the path of the sun, except for this 5-degree angle, which we already learned about, it's going to be in front of one constellation after the other. And these constellations have tremendous forces that they're raying in to the Earth. And the moon is like a gateway. It opens the door from one to the other, from the constellation to the Earth. And this is something which it's something which Maria Toon discovered, this particular rhythm, it's been known by astrologers, I think since Babylonian times, that the four elements are connected to the 12 constellations in a particular way. So, you know, Leo is a fire sign, Taurus is an earth sign, we know those things, and if you don't, they're in the beginning of it, it's in the key. And we know that the plant